Hey guys, welcome back. So I'm teaching another spell, a love spell with the demon Sitri, okay? Also commonly known as, because of his aura, his energy, his attitude, and that's why I encourage you, if you're in the area of looking for love work, that's got very high energy and a lot of lust involved, do invocation with Zeppa. Or contact me to do the spell for you, and I would actually teach you the thank you invocation as well to receive and be involved in the actual spell. Okay, so this is kind of it's a simple setup. It's what a lot of people term black magic, which is our other story. Okay, it's not what you think. So the setup is pretty simple. I'm gonna teach it to you now, and keep in mind the materials that I put together for this one has a very high frequency with the entity. Sitri, not Zeppa. I've just shot another word on Zeppa. So, sorry, we're talking about Sitri. These materials done correctly work very high with his frequency and energy, okay? So you're going to want to start with, if you're unfamiliar with this, you can do it with your own energy and no entity. You can do it with a numerous amount of different entities, but this one I specifically did with Sitri, okay? So you can check out my words on him. I have a few out on him, including the initial invocation with Sitri. And of course, for those who don't know, obviously I offer one-on-one video Skype consultations where we can either discuss the situation you find yourself in, any form of teaching you want to learn, whether it's accessing your higher self, doing shadow work for healing, talking about magic, entity. And of course, predominantly, I am a spellcaster. I'm there for you. I will cast a spell and teach you the thank you invocation. I have other offerings like deep invocation tarot readings, which I do with entity, and my Chaos Magic course, which comes with a free consultation with me as well. So getting into the spell, like I said, simple setup. On the side of your altar, right, you're going to have these two candles there, which is one black, one red. And this time, as always, his name will be scribed, but you're going to embalm it with olive oil. And then slightly in front, you're going to have two red candles, one year, your name, target's name scribed on there, okay? In the middle, you're going to have a glass jar with any type of lid on it, as long as it's not plastic, but a decent sized jar, okay? And in this jar, you're going to want to put two fresh chicken hearts. You're going to want to prick your finger somewhere. You're going to put 5 or 7 or 9 drops of blood in there. You choose, that's the amount you can put in there, okay? And then the target, for this one, there's no getting around it for this particular spell. You are going to need the target's hair, some of their hair, and a underwear, any underwear of theirs, whether it's used, been washed or not, but it has to have been worn at some point. That is the important part. And yes, for those wondering, an unwashed underwear garment has more energy attached to it for this spell. So if you can get your hands on an unwashed underwear piece, it's more powerful. Okay, then around the jar, you can put a whole bunch of fresh roses, olives, this is an important one, it's actually olives, and again, a couple of drops of blood, okay? So once the setup is there, guys, you're gonna call on entity with left hand down near his sigil. You're gonna have your petition, which is clearly written out, which will have his sigil drawn on it, his incantation on top. Right, so left hand down, right hand facing up, always balance. You're going to center yourself, you're going to calm yourself. You're going to dart your eyes between these candle flames and sigil, candle flames and sigil. And then you're going to acknowledge each and every single ingredient in the jar. You're going to acknowledge your candle, target's candle, see it all, close eyes. It is written on your petition. It is now going to be vibrated, spoken and seen, eyes closed. Welcome entity, glorify entity over and over, and then start thanking him that by his presence, his powers, these materials that are now one, that are now part of reality and your creation process, target, you use full names, is now lusting after you, longing after you, calling you, contacting you, and all the other love attachments to it, okay? And you work it for at least 10 to 20 minutes. You should feel drained afterwards. If not, I'm afraid you didn't do it correctly. You got to pour your energy into it. Once that's done, you leave candles burn for another 10 to 20 minutes. Snuff it out. Never blow them out. Repeat over 5 sessions. And again, these are good for practices because you're always entitled to interact with creation. That's why I teach. But if you want my teachings or any of my services, or you want me to do the spell for you and teach the thank you invocation, hit me up. I'm going to guide you. I'm going to help you. Okay? Be good. Or not.